Welcome back. In this session, we're going to take a look at our first Ruby data structures. These data structures will allow us to store more complex and interesting data. Up until this point, we've seen how we can use variables to store single pieces of data, a single number, string, or Boolean. Here's a string variable. This variable stores a single adorable puppy named Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. He's lonely. In this session, we'll see how we can cure our puppy's loneliness by storing a collection of other dogs together in the same variable, using what's known as an array. See, now he has a couple of friends. We'll also see how we can use Ruby hashes to store more detailed information about each dog. Dogs are more than just a name. We can add in an age for each dog. Let's also give them a breed. We now have a collection of dogs, where each dog consists of multiple pieces of information. By the end of this session, we'll be able to use Ruby arrays and hashes to store this type of complex data in code, whether we're working with dog data or real product data. Let's get started. Hip, hip, hooray!